Football, episode 100 on YouTube. Football.
Football.
Hey, and we are in here. It is football season, guys. Great for Earl to come in episode 100 and put a capper on the NBA season with just some potent takes, just straight coach speak. And that's what we're in training season right now, so we're all used to hearing coach speak. We'll get to John Gruden and the Oakland Raiders right now. Off the top, Hard Knocks is back on HBO and is featuring the circus that is the Oakland Raiders. Antonio Brown's feet are frozen and he can't do anything but run. I think he can do. Like, you guys watched the premiere, right?
He got feet chips.
Yeah, but you guys saw the finale, yeah, right? Like, no, if you were giving it a school grade, what would you grade the premiere? What would you grade the premiere?
A C.
C.
Very okay. average. Okay.
Yeah, I'd give it a blah plus.
Blah plus?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Make your own gradings.
Got to.
You used to get blahs in school?
Oh, that's man. I was lucky if I got a blah.
Redo.
I was lucky if I got
redo.
A blah.
And I want to say this too. Shouts out to college and me trying to get by as a student athlete. There's little tricks of the trade. Did you guys ever sometimes I would send in an email with the paper supposed to be attached, but it wasn't attached because I wasn't done with it. But I was supposed to send an email by the end of that day. You know what I'm saying?
Like a fake mistake.
I never turned it in. That is crazy. Huh, look at that. Like, you guys ever do that?
I've fake backdated emails before. Like, I sent this before, but I clearly didn't. And, like, think, like, technology was at fault.
Was that in Michigan?
Yeah.
Okay.
I did my work more in the font size and the margins. Than in the lack of attachments. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Get that 12 and a half, yeah, that 13. Like, yeah. 1.5-inch margin.
Those, a lot of those papers, the professor's guy's like, oh, this is that white privilege paper, yeah. right? Yeah. yeah. They went into the metadata to try to search this thing out. Anyways, speaking of white privilege, John Gruden is back on the screen, and we have Derek Carr, a very interesting, he's a football guy, and I will always defend football guys, but
he's also a Fresno guy.
Yeah, honestly, it makes me thankful my athletic ability and my ability to stay on my feet kept me out of the NFL, because if it was all about football and I never stopped, like, that's what I'd sound like. It would just be like, kids, wife, house, football.
Football, football, football.
Arms and jerseys.
Football.
Like, I'm going to say this too, and this is not shade. Like, shouts out to Antonio Brown. The highlights of him, for one, shouts out to football. Football looks beautiful on screen. Right, it is the grass, the angles. Like, we have the science and the formula for filming football to a T. It's some of the best television, reality TV show. It's the best show. Football is the best game and is the best show.
So therefore, the reality show around the football team is also good.
Yes, Hard Knocks is one of those things. It was like Chance the Rapper's album. It was better in theory than it is in actuality. Right, you watch it and you're like, oh yeah, this is a kind of like real sportsy too, and it's kind of boring, and the narrator is I mean, thank God for the narrators out there, but
yeah,
like,
the autumn wind stuff was pretty cool.
I'll tell you what though, the autumn wind remix,
yeah,
what?
No, I like that.
What,
I like
you
that.
Liked it?
Yeah.
I like the idea of trying to go to the modern version.
Like, this is,
but
like,
it has to be good. It can't be worse than the original.
Let me set up a narrator talking about a specific scene that I want to talk about in this. In the Hard Knocks, Antonio Brown have his kids from Napa, and they're on the field, and they want to see one of the old Steelers that they're used to seeing out there. And Antonio Brown's going to talk to his kids for the first time this summer. Him talking with his kids was very. Now, to be fair, there's a lot of them,
yep.
right? Like, to be able to row all of them all at once while also being one of the best NFL players, probably not easy to do, but it sounded like he was talking to his kids for the first time. I just want to say that and then put that take out there. Shouts out to the dads out there. Shouts out to Antonio Brown. Keep killing it. We're going to keep watching.
Do you think that their first word was dad or Roethlisberger.
Dad. Everyone's okay. It's always dad.
All right, cool. That's what I figured. But the way they three-year-old said Roethlisberger exactly.
And then he couldn't say Derek Carr. He said Derek Carter.
That's true. He made him a Carter. That was funny.
Let's keep it moving. Guys, we have a lot of preseason football games on today, yesterday for you guys, because we're uploading this on Wednesday, on Friday.
Today, tomorrow.
You guys know the outcome of these games by now, because these all games are going to be played tonight, even very late for the East Coast, because these are all LA times at 4 p.m. here. I mean, I guess the East has used to being up late and watching these games. I remember on the East Coast when I was living in South Orange, New Jersey, shouts out Chris Broussard's home to this day, it would be like 11:45 in like sometimes the fourth quarter was starting.
I don't miss those days.
Yeah. I've only known the West Coast watching life.
Yeah. So blessed. It's
glorious.
You're so blessed.
I can't imagine.
It's rough. It's rough. But anyways, Giants play the Jets. I'm going to go ahead and just roll the ball out there. Jets win. Everyone's talking very positively about Sam Darnold. He's the quarterback of the future. Le'Veon Bell has come out and he compared himself to LeBron, which I wanted to get to. I'm glad this came naturally. If you saw a quote out there, Le'Veon Bell was like, people tend to forget who you are. You know, if LeBron sent out for an entire season, you forget how good he is. It's just nature or habit or something like that. Le'Veon Bell is amazing. I will say we forgot what Le'Veon Bell looked like, but we do remember the fact that we did not see him is because of his own doing, right? Like, there's all kinds of theories of why he set out, but there's a setting out. Now, obviously, that could be great for football players. We've seen Ricky Williams. There's been plenty of guys who've come back and just was like tore
Sticky,
it up.
Icky, Ricky, right? My favorite player of all time.
But let's be real. There's some cobwebs that need to get worked out, and it's going to get worked up probably first, you know, four games of the season. He'll hit a stride, but it's not the same. It's not the same as LeBron.
I like him shooting for the basketball analogy, because that's what we do for our
job. No,
well,
that's hot in the summer.
But he missed a little bit. He's Kawhi.
Yeah, I was going to say definitely Kawhi.
Yes,
because we forgot about that. Kawhi when he was gone. But anyway, what else?
Colts, Bills. Who cares? Falcons, Dolphins. We'll pull for the Dolphins because I think the best way for the Dolphins to like even just gain relevancy is like beating teams that were good in recent history.
Well, I mean,
it's just like a raising eyebrow. It's like, you said the Dolphins beat the Falcons in the preseason game. Obviously, preseason games don't really matter. I wanted to text my friends, ask me even how many snaps they're even taking. Some of them might be taking a lot of snaps trying to stay on teams. But Patriots, Lions is next. Just heard Matt Patricia on a podcast. He's trying to do is he's trying to put it out of his sight and mind. He just wants to focus on the practice and winning the day. That's Matt Patricia's words.
Sharpen that pencil, your
guy.
The Lions be out here winning preseason games consistently.
I feel like we
might go 4-0.
Really, they might want to slow down and start trying to lose some of them games.
Right.
Start looking at the tape, like not exactly putting your best foot out.
Yeah.
And seeing what you do at half-stepping. But I love these games, too, because these are guys, like everyone who plays in a preseason game today, and there are a lot of preseason games today.
All of them,
how many games are today? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Every team's playing over the next 2-3 days.
Yes, because Saturday are big games. Let's talk about those Saturday games. Rams, Raiders. Shouts out to Hard Knocks.
John Gruden playing against his son.
Yes, that's going to be on the next Hard Knocks episode.
Yeah, that's that game. That's the must watch game because
those
watch
are
that,
fun.
And then, I mean, they might get it up to us on Tuesday. They might have a quick South Park s fast turn.
And get that game turned around for us on Tuesday night.
If there's
enough to watch, then we have preseason. The Chiefs versus the Bengals, a throttling of sorts. Best team versus the worst team.
Throttling.
You don't. Is that not a term?
Throttling, I think, is what you were looking for.
Nope.
Throttling.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Anyways, and then the Saturday Cowboys against your 49ers.
If this was 1995, that game would be so lit. Young.
Hey, not to be social right now, but it's more like 1995 than it isn't right now.
That's true.
I think that game still might be interesting because there's all kinds of trash and turmoil around it.
Baker's going on today. Against the R words.
Oh yes, Baker against the R words.
Dude, I want to see Haskins,
Dwayne
bro.
I want to see him, bro.
I said that.
I saw a spiral he threw on the internet. Woo!
Exactly, and I was saying because they're trying to feed into what I was saying. It could be there's going to be the social push for things now. Also, since we're talking about football, Kaepernick been without a job. He's been working out at 5 a.m. 5 days a week. And we're just seeing video of it now. I just want to put that out there. I'm very confused because The whole thing was like, we need to see that he's working out. Like, social media, you campaign for yourself there on social media pages. He knows that more than anyone else.
I think I have a question that'll work for this, because I was trying to figure out how to jump in here without just, you know, being a white devil. But
good luck.
Are push-ups good football workouts?
Yes, the best.
So if you just did, if you're him and you're just doing crunches and push-ups, that's getting you well on your way? Or, like, NFL should some of those practices include passes?
NFL players have told me, if you go on vacation with your family over this break, as long as you're doing 500 push-ups a day, you are in peak physical condition when you come back to start training again.
Whoa. And that is an interesting nugget, and I'm glad I asked.
Yeah, okay. So now you know. Jags, Ravens, that should be interesting. I'm going to watch that. Titans, Eagles, Texans, Packers, Chargers, Cardinals, Panthers, Bears. We're getting into the weeds of things that matter, because those
Vikings, Saints. You know, they've had some playoff matchups Broncos, of late.
Who do you say? Vikings, Saints. Today. Watch it today at 5 p.m. West Coast time, 8 p.m. East Coast time. That's going to be very interesting. Shouts out to Harrison Smith. Shouts out to Kyle Rudolph. Shouts out to the Saint, Michael Thomas. Got his payday. Should be interesting.
Football.
Steelers, Buccaneers tomorrow too. Mm. Today. That game is today. Watch that game today. Okay, moving on. Kevin Durant and Chris Haynes sat down together in L.A. Now, when you heard that Kevin Durant was going to give you something, you were like, I bet Chris Haynes going to be on it. He pulls up.
Real recognize real.
Shouts out to TJ McCollum and the money he got in the actual pull-up podcast, Jordan Schultz as well. Chris Haynes is doing it. It's just fun to see the Fresno boy getting mm-hmm. after it, getting in it. I remember watching him ask questions to LeBron after one of those finals losses. Yeah, that happens. Yeah, when he was working for ESPN. Guys, he's doing his thing. Go read an article, Kevin Durant, on if the Warriors mishandled his calf injury. Hell no. Is that actually the title?
Is
that the title?
Title of the digital article. Is Yahoo in print? As a member of, I guess, multiple Warriors-based group text threads.
Yes.
I just want to say to all of the people who are in those threads, see, I told y'all.
Yeah. He says.
Rumors are Durant's mad about whatever. Forget the rumors. What did he say?
There's an eye test, and I told y'all, I tweeted, y'all think he about to play a game the way he was limping around back there yelling at Drake after one of those wins? No, it's not going to happen. He went out there. He was trying to ball. He said, I'm just a guy out there trying to play basketball, and I just went out there and tried to play basketball. It's the biggest stage. He says it's going to be ingrained in his memory. Shouts out to the struggle. Shouts out to the journey. Like, we're all watching Kevin Durant grow, and he is the best basketball player that was in the league last year. Kawhi turned it on and was the best basketball player in the playoffs because of injury. But the rise will be documented as well as LeBron's, because LeBron is set up for quite the comeback as well.
One more thing on this Durant thing that I noticed in the article is that Blammo in the Photoshop on the Yahoo article, he's wearing a 35. So he said he was gonna wear a 7 in July.
I'm gonna say this.
They got him back. Chris Haynes is not gonna be wrong. No,
this is on Yahoo Sports. This on Yahoo Sports, and whoever the graphic guy is. They're selling the 35
this year while he sits out, and then he gets the 7 next year. I'm confused, anyway.
I think you are close to the situation to have much harder of a deep dive for it. I don't think it's even that serious. You're coming at Chris Haynes a little bit too, and like, you know what I'm saying?
he must be right.
I'm just saying, cool your jets a little bit. Hella said all that.
I'm gonna have to tweet at Rich Kleiman and find out what happened.
Okay, you know he called himself White Devil earlier today. And now it's time to check the tape. Okay, one of the biggest topics in sports news, call it slow, whatever you want to do, is Dak Prescott getting paid by the Cowboys. Zeke is still sitting out in Cabo. Protect your feet. You know, wear the booties if you're going to cryotherapy. You know what I'm saying? We need your feet to be all right, Zeke, sand when burns you come too. Back. Sandburn. Ooh, I was on the beach. Not to brag, but I was on the beach last Sunday working out. But Donnie came out. Yeah. Donnie came out to hang out. But before that, I went to hit the beach, did a workout. My feet almost blistered the way we did when we played volleyball that one day with Earl and Joy. We need to do it again. We need another team bonding thing. It's episode 100. Let's get the team bonding exercise in there. I say we should do Olympics. I want to race everybody. I want to
Everything's about race with you, man.
I want to play. It always is. I live in America. Excuse you. Dak Prescott needs to get paid. Joy talked about Dak and Tom Brady being compared to one another. Let's check the tape. Joy, talk to him.
Everyone is still barking and yapping about who should get paid first, and Zeke is saying he's not going to come back to training camp, which it's the Cowboys. Like
every year.
What would a Cowboy season be without Zeke doing something at the beginning of the year?
True. It's not what he
not
does.
Not the Cowboys. It's yeah, not what exactly. he does. Yeah, not what he does. No. He's on brand. So I think that Dak should be paid first. I don't understand the silliness about not paying your quarterback. They should have taken care of this a while ago. They should have done it before Carson Wentz's contract got done. But the one thing about Dak that I'm very high on, high key, is the things that Brady does, which is he's not out there, okay? He's not shotgunning beers. Not that I have a problem with that.
Right.
But I also want, if you're not that personality, don't do those things. Like, there was a time when Dak was hanging with Zeke. You remember the water gun incident?
Yeah, he was also in the club popping bottles with Zeke.
And it was like, no. Like, that's not you. Let's just stay on track. Dak is a very even-keeled guy. Mm-hmm. And to me, like, that is what I want in a quarterback. Like, I don't want you to be super high and super low. I don't want Odell-ness.
Yeah.
Again, love Odell.
True.
Perfectly fine with how Odell behaves. That's not the issue. I just don't want the quarterback doing that.
Right.
And there's a reason for that. Like, if you're a leader, you need to have leadership qualities. And it sounds corny and cliche, but it's just the truth.
No,
and
it's true.
The reason for the Cowboys being a winning organization right now is because of Dak Prescott.
Joy has the best of points. The Cowboys as a whole have found success, and their fandom that is everywhere around the nation that goes into hiding when they're bad has now immersed. They're out here. They're talking big crap, Cowboy gang, and have a good team to back up that trash talk. All that success is based solely around Dak Prescott and what he's been able to do at quarterback and how he's been able to manage that team since Tony Romo went down in the offseason. Dak has to get paid before Zeke. Simple as that. Your quarterback, I have been slow on Dak because I'm not sure where his personality has been. Some of the endorsement deals, and it's all stupid, petty stuff, and everyone trying to reach and trying to pull cards. You know how we irrationally judge each other and we catch each other slipping, right? Dak is a perfect quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys. The face of the NFL, the cornerstone, the Dallas Cowboys star might be right next to the shield and the most important logos in football. And we have a black quarterback who is handling the situation very maturely and getting out there and just going to play football because he knows at the end of the day, winning cures all. He's had his fun with Zeke. He's gotten to the party. Heller just showed me tape of him getting knocked out after a bowl game when he was at Mississippi State. Like, I'm cool with all that because that's just proof that a person is a football guy. You know, we party hard, we play harder.
People grow too.
Yeah, exactly. There's a structure to this whole thing, and it's all about elevation in life and getting better. And Dak Prescott has shown to do that. He has some games where he just completely disappears while he's on the field, but makes plays every now and then. But that's better than Carson Wentz, who literally has to be removed from the field and can't play. And he is the franchise quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles. And I wish him all the luck and health because I really do want to compare Dak Prescott and Carson Wentz. Joy said in episode 100, the bold take that Dak Prescott will have a better career than Carson Wentz. I want to be able to get valid proof of that, yes or no. We can only get that if Carson Wentz plays and Dak plays and Carson got paid. Pay Dak. End of story. End of discussion. Now it's time for King Comments. We are here. We are in the comments. It is episode 100. Congratulations to us. Congratulations to you all. Congratulations to us all. A crazy game as a team. It's been a lot of hours of you guys watching. Shouts out. Minute on minute on minute. A lot of us, hours of us working, content creating, editing, posting, talking, taking.
Taking.
Woo! Sports taking.
Yeah, I see. Yeah,
okay,
yeah. Giving
takes. Exactly. So,
it's a verb.
Guys, I appreciate it. If you never know how I end up landing here, I worked as a social media producer for Fox Sports. Got started, speak for yourself, social media handle. Maybe I'm sorry, Undisputed's social media handle. That's where I met Joy officially and started working with her. She knew me from around the office. We've done some things on the herd together because anytime the herd guy was out, I would cover for him. Fun fact, 4th of July, when Kevin Durant decided to go to the Warriors, I was running the Herd account. Nick Wright was subbing in for Colin. Colin was only going to speak for yourself that day. He came in and sat on his couch for the first time while Nick Wright interviewed him for the KD News, and we went over Whitlocks and had In-N-Out after that day. But just a fun fact. This is what I'm saying. I've been in the game for a little bit. You know what I'm saying? The social media stuff, this YouTube stuff. This is what I do. This is my profession. Joy saw I was doing some stuff with my friends, TV shows, comedy stuff, and she gave me an opportunity, and now we're here. Updates, Brandon Newsman, episode 100.5. Guys, make sure you go check out Kobe Bryant's Diet Jordan, episode 100 with Earl Watson, guys. He just spilled out information. It was so good, so fun. He always just gives you just a condensed, just knowledge, and it's just like quotes upon quotes in book form. You can tell the man reads.
He's like a professor.
Yes. He's a basketball knowledge professor.
Yes.
Yes, we need to get Earl Professor Watson. That sounds perfect. That
sounds nice.
Professor Watson.
Yeah, it rolls.
The basketball, he now has a BA. He's an NBA BA. Okay, shouts out to Earl Watson. I actually don't know if it's BA, BS. I don't know what he got it in, but shouts out to Earl for being here. Guys, we're going to get into the comments. You guys have been very nice in the comments. I'm giving you a little bit more time to talk about this because it is episode 100, special time. Joy is in NABJ, representing Fox Sports right now. Shouts out, it's Miami this year. It's hot Miami. It's like prep for NFL. This is like prep for NFL Super Bowl week.
Humid too. Yes, yeah.
But this is like, no, I'm like hot like people there. It's here. Like, anyways, let's get into the comments. Digital Tiger 77 said, LL J. Cole isn't even 600. Guys, don't judge him for his last album or the one before that. The mixtape Dreamville stuff, or the album the Dreamville, that's a great album. J. Cole can spit. Don't do that. 600.
Can he list 600 rappers? I challenge him to list 600.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Oh. 600 rappers? You gotta go.
That's deep.
You gotta start naming some of your friends.
Yeah.
Shouts out to Nick Miles and J. New, two of my friends that I put in my top 600. Tony S. The internet was created for porn and arguing. LOL. That was a bar by Joy right at the top. The title of this video is disrespectful. We got you. LOL Joy. Love the realness. Big ups to Earl. Always shouts out to Earl. Alrighty then. Ooh, Ace Ventura Avatar. Shouts out to everybody that's been down. Arrow, down arrow, emoji. Since every other comment was about Joy being a snack, we're going to leave that in because it was a problem at one point. It was all snack talk. Snack talk. Then we had snacks on. Shout out to one of my favorite guests outside of Earl on the podcast. Before we had White Walls in here, me and Snack Harrison became blood brothers because we both agreed that we could time up jumping out of an airplane and probably roll and be okay. Good luck to him this season.
Go Lions.
Kobe's a great player, but he's not the GOAT conversation. He's not even top 100. Top 20, yes, but not top 10. The fact that he's top 20 player of all time is a major accomplishment. Please stop overrating this man. I think it's all subjective. I think Kobe's top 10 basketball player in my book.
Oh, yeah.
In NBA history?
Without a doubt.
Yeah.
You start whittling it down, that's when the conversation gets interesting.
Yeah, like Tim Duncan's in my top 10 too, which is like people can like turn their nose up at, but like fundamental, like I'm just going to leave it there. Dominic's in here. Congratulations to everyone involved. One of my favorite podcasts out there. Been watching since Undisputed Days. Let's get to 200 episodes. Hey, appreciate you. Did this woman put Lil' Kim over Lauryn Hill? Please sit to sports. See, this is the thing. It seems like I can't read because you say, please sit to sports. And I'm like, my brain's like, is that what it says? Sit to sports? Don't say that out loud, Brandon. It says sit to sports. Come on,
just spell
Jabari.
Check.
And then he said, this is the same guy who says, I can't talk basketball and it's irritating. Well, you can't write sentences and it's irritating for me. And I love you, Jabari, because you commented twice, so I appreciate it. Yeah. And it looks like you got some traction. Got some replies. But come on. Neon Quilt, we're going to give you some, because you shade, and I like it. You're the quintessential, let me say this. Neon Quilt is the quintessential YouTube commenter for our page. Shouts out to you and all the others like you. Congrats on the 100th episode, even though I disagree most of the time. I won't hate. I do have two complaints, though. One, you guys must not understand bars. If MF Doom and Rakim is not in your top three. Listen, like, I've done my research. Like, I did that thing where, like, if I'm going to be a hip-hop fan, I got to, like, go back and, like, listen to stuff. I was very, very impressed with Rakim when I was growing up and I first, like, was like, ooh, like, he was... You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like Rakim.
Eric B.
Eric B.
Yeah. Ahead of their time. Their styles, I feel like, were like not of the time, which made them stand out. So.
Right. Yeah. And that's why, like, shout out to LL Cool J. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, honestly, Will Smith, like, he's somebody who raps very well and never cursed.
He was a good storyteller, too.
Yes. And I did say sorry to Eminem because, like, it feels blasphemous, but, like, I want him to be his healthiest self, and his healthiest self making music isn't the best.
Agreed.
So I can't, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's real.
Like, I want people to be good and like mentally sane and rap.
Yeah, that's dope of you.
Right? You know what I mean? And I didn't put Kanye in my top five because there's reason to believe both Pusha T, Sigha the Prince, Big Sean, like a lot of those people in those camp have written bars for him. So I don't know he's a great songwriter. If I had a top five greatest song creators for hip hop genre, Kanye would be number one. Everyone's fighting him, biting him. Watch the Throne turn 8 today.
Oh, that's weird. Time flies.
I was listening to that today, just like, it was so good. And that's what I'm saying, like, for Kanye to take, I mean, he's an actual Trump supporter, and for him to take the train that he's gone, it's a little left, and, you know, he can't be in my top five. Miguel Swaggerito, we talked about him.
Swaggero.
Swaggero. Shout out to Swaggero. congrats on 100. I don't know how long I've been around. I remember Undisputed uploads. I'm here for whatever comes next. Hey, shouts out to you.
Dope.
My first watch, dope. Congrats on 100 episodes. Welcome. He's like, yeah, something like that, yeah.
Welcome.
Shouts out Leo Jen 87. That's probably like one of those like joint accounts between two like couples.
Oh yeah.
Like, no,
we're
gonna have one YouTube account. Jen was like, Leo, we got one account and we was born in 87.
Jen is checking his history.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Shouts out to Leo Jen. Okay, this actually might be the last quote because it's just a lot here. So Junior Coleman, shouts out. You are the last comment read on episode 100.5. We'll name this podcast later. Here we go. Junior Coleman. You always have to respect it when someone like Earl gives content on the game. Brandon hating on Zion already. Damn. Damn spelt like the thing that stops water. Just want to put that out there. Okay. Damn. Angry Beavers.
great show.
Yes, exactly. Shout out.
Classic.
Oh, and Barry, Isaac Hayes was on there. He was
You're right.
Oh, gosh. Okay. Zion's going to put the Pelicans on the NBA scene. Okay, let me address that. Agreed. I think Lonzo is going to be somebody who does that. Lonzo Ball, you guys remember, he was the second draft pick, supposed to save the Lakers. LeVar says they weren't playing him enough. Luke Walton, it was all trouble and stuff, but I'm happy to see Lonzo rebirth. I'm excited, but I am not hating on Zion. I just want to temper expectations so we get the best version of Zion that we possibly can as early as we can.
You're setting yourself up to be... entertained.
Yeah, I mean, like, I want to be pleasantly surprised. Okay, my friends, it has been fun. Thank you. I love you from the bottom of my heart, guys. You don't know what these last 4 years have been for me, to even have a platform, to be on a podcast, to have a job where I have an opinion on the things that I love to consume on a daily basis is truly a blessing. I'll get better at talking basketball. I'll get better at talking football. I'll get better at making you laugh. Your grandmother's going to love me. I mean, your kids are going to love me. I'm telling you. Like, the kids. It's about the kids. I'm Lil Nas X in my way into your homes, guys. And I appreciate you guys. Shouts out to Joy Taylor, the mother of Maybe I'm Crazy, for birthing this thing from the concept. It's a lot of hard work, a lot of grind that we put into this thing, a lot of thought processes, a lot of text messages in the group thread. We love you guys. We thank you. Cheers to 100 more. Maybe I'm Crazy. We out.